Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm your host Vikas Chandra Pitirilla. Let's do your reading for the month of March 2021 for Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus and Jupiter signs for the sign of Gemini. And I'll continue with the Golden Dawn Spirit. I'm getting with your situation, your alternate path, your current path, your alternate path, your psychological basis and karma. Your current path, alternate path, psychological basis and karma. Alright guys, now the cards are drawn. Let's do the face up and see what cards we have. Alright guys, now the face up of the cards are done. Let's get into your reading. Starting with the situation, you got Ace of Cups, Star and Failure. Now in your reading I got a lot of cards which are related to Libra also, and since when I started YouTube, every time I say that you might be connecting with Libra a lot, and still I feel like you're connecting with them. So I feel like you are helping each other very well. You can check out Libra reading, okay? This is not a joke. All the cards which they got, you are also getting. Star, Hermit, I'll tell you, see. Star, Hermit, Ace of Swords, Lust, Indolence. They got Strife, Hierophant. So, 6, 7. So 7 out of 15, it's almost 50, okay, 50% almost. So that's good, and that's a good thing, because air sign should have a good contact with another air sign in order to help, you know, elevate the element of air, which is basically you. So good, let's get into your reading with situation, Ace of Cups, Star and Failure. As I said, in this star also Libra got, which is exactly the center. Now you're I feel like you're balancing out, and this is with regards to your failure and happiness, something to do with failure and happiness. You're trying to balance it out is what I am feeling, okay? You can see this star, this lady or a woman, or I would like to call girl, okay, because star usually is a very not very old, okay? Not very old. This star represents very young, is what I feel. And even this woman looks very young, okay? You can see she is balancing this as above, so below. She has two cups, which represents balance. And you also are drawn to spirals, okay? Some spirals and something to do with, yeah, spirals, something to do with the round, and it can be any shape, because you can see in the failure you got, which is disc, which is also round, okay? So round, anything which is round and spiral, like this is also like a spider pattern, but it is round, okay? So star represents that you are actually using your natural abilities in order to balance your life with regards to failure and happiness, okay? Because happiness is star card. This is the situation right now. Happiness is ace of cups, okay? Balancing represents you're trying to choose 50% of happiness and 50% of failure. It's not that. Balance represents trying to, whenever you feel happy, trying to really be happy such that you're happy for a long term, to trying to sustain that is what I mean, because it's a vibration, right? Trying to sustain that happiness. And when it comes to failure, you're again trying to see how you have to sustain that, whether you have to sustain that or whether you have to leave. Whenever you're leaving something, you want to leave with a positive note, something like that. You're trying to balance it out. It's nothing is extreme. When it comes to happiness, you're not extremely happy. When it comes to sad, you're not extremely sad. It's kind of calm, is what you're trying to balance. That that's a situation. Nothing is too extreme, so your emotions are quite stable in a way. We can see that your situation, your emotions are quite stable. You're trying to balance it out naturally. This is something not, you're not forcing it. It's naturally happening with the star card. Let's get into your current path. You got Magus, Hierophant and Strife, two major arcanas here, so it's improving. Same like Libra, they got one major arcana in the situation. When it comes to current path, they got two. So one is becoming two. So you're in a very good flow, okay? So go with the flow. Your current path is Magus, Hierophant, it's right with the Magus card. Look, again, you can see this guy is balancing. He's juggling basically, but he's trying to balance. He's walking in this thin rope and trying to balance. There's a lot of representation of balance. So your life is balanced. You have the ability. Magus represents magician. He has the ability to walk. He has the talent to balance things out. He has the talent to juggle. There is radio waves and everything. Yeah, even that represents in your life in month of March. But mainly, since it is coming with the balance story, I'm trying to take up with that. And yeah, you might be connecting with radio waves also. You might be using a lot of tools near you and trying to use those tools. But I feel like, yeah, you might be also connecting with old items, some artifacts or something like that. And you're also very happy with the Magus card. You are happy that you're able to balance things out, okay? See, I can see a smile on his face. He's very happy. He's not concerned of whether he'll fall, because he believes that he can walk in this thin rope and balance himself out. So you're not worried, because you know that you can do this. You know that you can balance your emotions, and you're doing it. At the same time, while you're doing it, you're quite happy that you're able to do that. We got Hierophant, which is also teacher. So you might be teaching others also what has happened to you and stuff like that, and you might be enlightening other people and trying to teach them in a way that how you experienced. Whenever you teach others, I feel like they feel like they have experienced themselves. You know, that level of teaching is what I am feeling, and absolutely, it's absolutely amazing. You know, with the next to magician, it's Hierophant is absolutely amazing. I can't see it much better. It's absolutely amazing. Okay, because we got Magus, which is one. We got Ace of Cups also, which is one. We got five over here, Five of Wands, Strife. We also got fifth card in Major Arcana, which is Hierophant. So you know where is this going? It's everything balanced. We got one Magus, we got one in the situation. We got fifth card, Major Arcana, which is Hierophant. You can see five Roman numeral over here at the top. And this is numbered five, which is Minor Arcana, so it's numbered five. This is numerical, this is Roman numerals, okay? So Major Arcana is represented by numbers, and this is Major Arcana is represented by Romans, and Minor Arcana is represented by numbers. So 5 and 5, so 1 and 1, okay? So balanced, Magus and Ace of Cups, everything is balanced. With the Strife card, same thing. You believe and move forward, okay? So this is a Strife. Strife represents you putting your effort. So your current path is absolutely good. Keep doing what you're doing, that's it. Keep doing what you're doing with the Hierophant, belief, and also teach others how you have done it. And it will definitely help a lot with the Hierophant. Many people will be listening to what you're seeing and trying to really see with your perspective. And absolutely, it's amazing. And you can see, you might not know with the Hierophant card, I'm sensing that you might not know. If you start teaching one person, automatically you'll never know that. You think like you're teaching one or two people, but what is actually happening in the background is you're teaching 5-6 people. Because there are a lot of many people who are actually listening to you in the background. I'll show you the symbolism over here, why I got that message. With the Hierophant, you can see there is a mask over here, which is actually represented. Mask is represented covering a face and trying to not reveal its face. So it is in the background. There are many people in the background trying to actually listen what you're saying and trying to feel what you're seeing and trying to really feel it as if they have experienced it. And you might think that you're teaching one particular person or two people. Usually he's signing two over here. I feel like you might be teaching one or two people, but there's a lot of people, like 5-6 people, who are actually being guided and being taught by your words. It's amazing. So keep striving with the Strife card, and believe that, you know, with the Strife card and Magus, and man, you can see with the Strife, you have to just move forward and believe that you can move forward. And if, oh man. See, you believe in yourself that you can walk in the tightrope, but when universe says that just move forward, then when universe is saying, then just keep on doing it. With the alternate path, we got Peace, Hermit, and Art. Again, two major arcanas, which is awesome. Alternate path meaning that rather than your current path, this is what you can alternately do. Okay, this is not again advice. It doesn't mean that your current path is not good. This is something that we can alternately do. Okay, if you don't feel like your current path is good, then you can get into your alternate path. But it is here for you. Okay, Two of Swords, which represents peace and also contemplation and also resolution. Okay, with the peace, you're getting resolution and also contemplation. You're also trying to decide. Okay, you can also do this. Okay, you can find a resolution in your life with whatever you're doing right now. You can find a contemplate on yourself, you know, just not do anything, just sit and just contemplate. Okay, this is a very good practice. This is very good art. I was about to say art, and you got art in the alternate path. So yeah, you can just contemplate. Try contemplation. Okay, just I feel like when you contemplate, you can try to decide which direction you have to go, whether right or left. And you can see in the Rider-Waite also, it's beautifully represented. She'll be sitting in the table, sitting in the chair, and her eyes will be covered with a white cloth. That means she's using a third eye and she's just contemplating. So that's what it represents. You can try contemplation. If you do try contemplation, this is what will happen. Hermit meaning that you'll find answers, you'll dig deep into what is happening. This is the cosmic egg. You'll find the secrets also. This is the lamp. You can see carefully, if you look carefully, this is the hand, this is the lamp, and this is a man who is arching like this. This arch represents experience. So with the experience, you're trying to move forward, which is balance, usually balance. It's in your motion, okay? It's in your subconscious mind. It's in your muscles. It's embedded, okay? It's programmed in your muscles. That's why if you learn how to cycle, you'll never forget that, because it'll be programmed in your muscles. It subconsciously happen next time you ride. So that's what your subconsciously, you can balance yourself. This is the arch, this is the experience. This can, you can alternately do is that you can just search answers by contemplating. Okay, this is the lamp, this is the cosmic egg. You find the answers. Also, contemplate in a way that you look back, not forward, because you can find this DNA, which represents birth. Okay, so since you're a small, you know, guy or a girl, try to get the perspective and resolution of you being a small, when you are a small person, and try to contemplate on that way. And there is various different ways of contemplation, so you can try that method. This is an art. This is what I was about to tell you, and I saw the art card. Everything happens for a reason, okay? I got a psychic message of art in my mind, and I got art, okay? Of course, I read that art, and it is instilled in my mind at that time. But Two of Swords represents contemplation, Hermit represents seeking answers, art represents art simply. So these things never, you know, this is the mystery of tarot. This is something, this is the most mysterious thing. And every tarot reader says that we are telling answers not because it's our, it's kind of funny, but every tarot reader says that, even I believe that we are not doing the work over here. 90% of the thing, it's the tarot which is doing the work. I don't know, I'm just the medium of just telling you what it means. But it surprises everyone who says that, who listens to that. And I don't know, I feel like just cards just come out, and even though I don't have to think what is that, it just naturally comes. The story starts to build up, and even the cards will have a particular meaning that if I put any other card with respect to Hermit right now, the meaning totally changes. So I don't know how it goes on, you know. It's a very mysterious thing, and that's what tarot would design for. Okay, we let the universe decide the probability, the combinations, and trying to use the probability as a tool for helping us. Okay, there is a lot of numerology, there is a lot of astrology, there's a lot of permutation and combinations happening. There's a lot of universal things which are happening. And me placing the card in particular distance, particular angle, every single thing. Me doing a reading over here and everything. There's a lot of vastu, there's a lot of magnetism, everything. So all this combined with the same thing, everything. You can see there's cups over here, there's fire over here. When you combine everything, that's when you can create this, you know, the cup of happiness, which is over here. You can see this cross, it represents Knights Templar. You might be connecting with old movies. You might watch old movies, especially related to something related to war and old age times. And if I can explain much deeper, but we don't have time right now with the cards, I'm trying to shorten it out, but this is what you can alternately do. You can use your contemplation and try to find answers by looking back. Especially you can imagine you being having a resolution and thinking about you being a young person, or when you are a young person, how your life went and the directions of your life and where the light took you to who you are right now. So this contemplation is definitely good. It will find you secrets of life and also answers. You got in psychological basis, you got Ace of Swords, Lust and Cruelty. Now with the Ace of Swords, I was actually studying about this card just before I started, even before I started Libra reading. I was actually, I took the Book of Thought, the book which I got from this deck actually along with it. I was studying about this card, you know, I pre-shuffled and I just took one card out of it. This card popped out and I was studying about this card just before I started Libra reading. And it said that this inscription in the sword is this is a Hebrew language, I believe. It's called Thelema or Will. Okay, so there is willpower basically. They said will, but I said power. I don't know why. There is willpower. This represents will and this represents power. Willpower. And this is the moon, okay? This is the crescent moon. You can see two moons and three suns. The solar sun, okay? Lunar moon. Why many people ask why it is lunar? Why they kept that name? Because there is a goddess called Luna. It's also called Selena or something like that. The many names. So Luna is a goddess. So it is represented by that goddess, Luna. So lunar. Also drink water. Because every time you say about moon, you're connecting your mind to the moon, and moon represents sensuality and your mind. It also represents water, okay? Moon, it controls the water tides, okay, and everything, cycles of the moon. So whenever you're talking about moon, you can automatically see you're either feel thirsty or you feel like you're kind of filled with water. You're hydrated. You either feel dehydrated or you feel very hydrated. It's up and down when you talk with the moon, because everything is cycle with the moon. It's up and down. It's a very big sine wave, okay? It's the transfer of waves is very big, okay? So that's what happens with the moon. There is actually two crescent moons and three suns, the solar. And this might be significant. You might be connecting with the sun more, and even moon also a little bit. So because there are three, you might be connecting with the sun more, and moon too. So yeah, a good amount of moon energy also you might be connecting with that. And this is helping you to shine brightly in the society, the moon energy and sun energy. And all this is represents sky, adverse sky, which represents element of air, which is swords. So coming in the psychological basis, psychologically, even the moon and sun energy is helping you to help gain the willpower of yours and trying to shine brightly in the society. And the sky represents you being in top of the world and just shining brightly like the sky. Like, you know, the sun shines brightly from the sky, the moon shines brightly from the sky. It's the element of air, okay? You got Lust card next to it. I feel like what you're doing in the current path is trying to teach also and trying to balance your life. That is the current path what you're doing. What is happening in the background is much more awesome, is that you're shining brightly in the world and people can see you. When people can see you, people can come to you. So universe is trying to make you shine brightly so that people can get to you very quickly and easily. So because something is illuminating and something is shining, we try to get attracted easily and trying to reach that, trying to get that easily. So something which is visible, okay, you'll be very visible is what I'm seeing in this March month. And with the lust card also, yes, she's kind of naked, but the representation of that is you being visible, basically. Okay, naturally, you being visible. And that's what lust represents. Lust represents something which you're getting after, like this snake, Rahu. And you can see the snake also. Beautiful tarot deck this is. And every key element and key word has been represented in the card. There's nothing which is left. Everything has been purposefully made in the card. So lust represents you being visible and people are getting attracted to you. The reason for this lust that people are getting is that when you're visible and when you're popular and when you're illuminating and shining brightly, people get attracted and you teach with the Hierophant card, which you're actually doing. So that is what is happening in the background. See, once you're teaching, usually people get attracted to listen, and that lust comes. That's a lust card, okay? And also people will get to know you, okay? I feel like new people will come to your life right now in the month of March, for sure. Because when you're teaching, there'll be other people who you don't know, and they try to listen what you're saying, and they'll try to get to know who you are. Even though you're not physically teaching or speaking, this is the psychological thing. This is in an energetic level. So everything, even though it is not physically done, if it is in an energetic level or psychological level, you will manifest things in that perspective with the energy level. Okay, everything is same. If you do physically, it doesn't mean that it is different from how you do mentally. Both will give the same results, but both will give the same results in a way that how it has to be, how it has been done. Okay, if it is physical, it will be physical result. If it is mental, if you do mentally, it will be a mental result. If it is a psychological thing, it will be a psychological result. So, but the result remains same if you put in one particular intention and like the teaching thing. Now with the Cruelty card, Nine of Swords. Now this is what happens, and this is not that this doesn't really matter is what I'm saying. That's the word. This doesn't really matter, because what doesn't really matter is when you teach others, they may not give the credit that you have taught them. When you teach others, they might learn, or either two things can happen with the Nine of Swords. When you teach at night time, because Nine of Swords is night, usually he'll be sleeping in the bed with the Rider Waite. So yeah, at the night, they'll be contemplating at this, and they'll be thinking that, okay, this is a wonderful thing. This can change people's life. There'll be a lot of hard work, which is just bleeding away, which means just gone away, the hard work and everything. They'll also feel quite sad that they didn't know before, but it's them who have that vibration. But I feel like you have to teach, and among five members, of course, two or at least one person will be quite having this greedy mindset, that you know the vibration won't be good usually. So that doesn't really matter. At least out of 5-4 people are getting benefited. So keep on teaching that. Okay, this is happening in the background. And usually when a person feels that greediness, it means that they have to learn even more and take that even deeply. And every person has a particular karma and particular way of experiencing life and learning life. So they are experiencing and learning life in that way, so let them do that. Okay, let's look at your karma. Indolence, abundance and defeat in your karma. So yeah, you're with the defeat card, basically enemies, the same thing. Whoever are listening to your teachings, they'll be enemies also, but you will defeat them naturally. Because this is Five of Swords, this also presents fifth house, which is defeat. It's amazing. Oh my god, astrology and tarot are related, I don't know how. In astrology, fifth house represents house of enemies. You got Five of Swords, which is defeat, And tarot, this is tarot basically, five of swords represents defeat. So astrology and tarot is intertwined, and it's, and you know, there is a story that tarot is not made for astrology purposes and predictions, but it just happened. Why? It's because universal thing. Universe has made it happen. Universe has made it happen that way. Okay. Yeah, with the defeat card, with the five of swords, anyone who is trying to have this enemy mindset and negative mindset, automatically, you know, they will have your aspect of the fifth house and they can't do anything. Everything will be gone. Okay. So something, a very beneficial planet like Jupiter or Venus. So I have Venus in the 11th and it's looking at 5th. So all enemies are, I don't have to do anything. If there is any enemy, I don't have to do anything. Naturally, after some time, they will get drained and they can't just keep up with my energy. They can't just fight. Okay, it can't happen. Especially with Venus, it can't happen. So I am actually blessed. Okay. So there's definitely a more beneficial planet. I think Jupiter is also very good, and definitely many other planets can actually have the good aspect that can, you know, take away the enemies, okay, instantly. So you might be having that. And coming with the abundance, it's because you have to be abundant, and any person who's trying to interfere in that naturally has to go. That's why you got defeat card. And with abundance, yeah, if you get abundance, a lot of jealousy and enemy naturally. So yeah, cruelty, defeat, the same thing. But you have to experience the abundance. You have to be abundant. This is what you have to be sure. You might be inviting other people for teaching, or, you know, just hanging out and having a nice, you know, nice time. You know, you might be having a good time with them. So sharing emotions and being happy with the three of cups, that's the meaning. Okay, with the karma also. Wow, I feel like with the three of cups, I also got a psychic message before also. Where was that? Yeah, lust and hierophant and three of cups, guys. You might be, oh my goodness, oh my goodness, if we actually take, yeah, there is a lot of other things also which are helping that, but very prominently, again, partially star card also is helping, but prominently hierophant, which is in the center of the reading, in the, which is in the center of the current path, lust, which is in the center of the psychological basis, and abundance, which is three of cups, in the center of the karma. Anything which is center is major. Coming these three signifies only one thing, is that you'll definitely make new people, you'll definitely meet new people, you'll definitely come across new people, and trying to get to know each other and trying to share emotions, get connected. Yeah, you'll definitely get connected with new people, absolutely. Okay. Because there's a lot of partially lot of cards are there, but this is prominent. Lust, hierophant, three of cups. I can also see signs. I can give sign, zodiac sign. Hierophant would be Taurus, maybe a little bit of Virgo, and with the lust it will be Leo for sure, nothing else. Maybe Aries, but prominently Leo. Definitely Leo person might be definitely be there in that, whatever, whoever, new people, it might be multiple people, but if in that, definitely Leo person will be there. Maybe Taurus and Virgo, because Hierophant might be Taurus and Virgo. There is a lot of Saturn effect also. Saturn would be very strong in the chart. Okay. Leo and the other person, Saturn might be very strong. Maybe, yeah, Jupiter also might be very strong. Jupiter might be very strong than Saturn. And with the three of cups, abundance, Cancer. And someone who has a lot of emotions, and because of this emotional person, might be that you might meet these other two people. It might be three people or more, usually I think four, five, more than three usually with star. And because of this, with the star, I can give Aquarius also. Okay, so Aquarius, maybe Aquarius, Leo, Taurus and Virgo. and Cancer. And because of this Cancer person or someone who has water sign, Cancer Pisces Scorpio, he's trying to help you to get new people and try to meet new people. And with indolence, I feel like it's not one day. Usually it's not within one day, because cups are not filled, only few cups are filled, so it will take time. And this is not within one day, it takes time, okay? But in the month of March, you definitely meet new people, definitely more than one for sure. Yeah. And if you like the reading, click the like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe and click on the bell icon to get notified and never miss any video. Also, you can actually follow me on social medias like Facebook. I have a Facebook page and an Instagram account. All the social media links are below, also in the description. You can follow me there. I'll post you with the latest updates. I'll post every time I upload any video. I'll actually direct that link towards my Facebook page and upload it as soon as I upload any video on YouTube. So you'll get notified on YouTube, on Facebook, and you know, I have a Twitter account also. I'll post it there, and also in my on my Instagram status I post it, okay? So you can follow me on Instagram as well in order to get notified in all the directions, so that anytime you get notified in any other way in my social media, you get notified that my video is up there. So because YouTube, when you click on the bell icon, it does get notified for you, but still I believe it's better, you know, you subscribe to all my social media links and stay updated that way. Until then, I'll catch you guys in the next one. And if you want a personal reading, you can check out my business card. I do tarot readings, astrological readings, life coaching, and daily readings. And these are my services, and my price ranges also shown respectively. You can find my social media links and phone number there. Until then, I'll catch you guys in the next one. Thanks for watching, and thanks for the support. Thank you.